It's wonderful to see you all in Karimnagar. I'm very sorry I'm not able to speak in Telugu. It's a very wonderful language. Trying my best to learn. I'll be talking in English. And if there is a translation needed, I request you to kindly inform us so that somebody can translate. Friends, I am extremely delighted. We have come to Karimnagar today to canvass, to seek votes on behalf of a wonderful political leader, Bandi Sanjay Garu. We all know there is a definition of leadership, how a leader should be. A leader should be from the ground. He should reflect the people's aspiration. And leaders should be ready to sweat it out, even to give their blood for a larger cause. If you are looking at the history of India, many leaders are created by fighters on the ground. They are big fighters on the ground. If you look at Telangana politics for the last couple of years, Telangana has given not only a leader from Karimnagar, it has given a leader for South India, it is Bandi Sanjay Garu. Fighter, if we can say one person in Telangana who was able to bring the BRS government down, it is Bandi Anna. As a single person who fought every single day he fought. In fact, Tamil Nadu, our Yatra, Enman Enmakkal Yatra, was designed based on Bandi Anna's Yatra. Our team here, I came twice to Anna's Yatra. Our team came to Telangana. They studied the Yatra's model. Then our Yatra, Enman Enmakkal, was designed in Tamil Nadu. Such a great Yatra which happened in Telangana. I never seen any political leader getting arrested. Every single day he is getting arrested for one or the other reason. Not allowing him to do Yatra. He was the person who broke open the question paper leak scam. He was arrested. He was the person who questioned BRS government on corruption. He was arrested. I think he was arrested 4 or 5 times. He fought for you all. He was the voice of Telangana for a long, long time. Now the only problem is, the current Congress government is much worse than BRS government. In Tamil we say, pay vendam endru sonnom boodham vandavittar. In English the translation is, we did not want a devil, but instead a Buddha came. So we did not want a BRS. It is a government Congress which is much worse than BRS, which is in power now. That is why, brothers and sisters, it is again very important. Bandi Anna has to win with a larger mandate, larger margin. Right now he is Bharatiya Janata Party's All India General Secretary. A very important organizational position. Our Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji, our National President JP Nadda ji, our Home Minister Amit Shah ji, they wanted Bandi Anna to grow the party across South India. Now he is made as our National General Secretary. But all of us, we need to be very, very clear. Bandi Anna is needed in Telangana till Congress is also dislodged from Telangana. He has to be the voice of Karimnagar. He has to be the voice of Telangana. All the youth who have come here, we all know Bandi Anna is a youth icon of Telangana. Why do we call him a youth icon? Why do we call him a youth icon? Only because he reflects the aspirations of youth. He reflects the aspirations of our thinking. He stands up for corruption. He stands up for family rule. He stands up against the dynastic politics. That is why the youth of Telangana are behind Bandi Anna. And even in this election, it's a foregone conclusion. Whatever setting politics, BRS and Congress, they are going to do in Karimnagar, Bandi Anna is going to win with a historic mandate once again from Karimnagar on May 13th, when counting is going to happen on June 4th. We all know the people of Karimnagar will speak in one voice. That is the voice of Bandi Sanjay Reddy Garu. Brothers and sisters, now one thing we have to understand. During the assembly election also, Bandi Anna was telling all of us that Congress, all the 6 guarantee, they are not going to fulfill even a single guarantee. You look at all the Congress 6 guarantee. They said if we come to power, for each woman in Telangana, each mother, each sister in Telangana, we will give 2,500 rupees every month, which is 30,000 rupees every year. They said each LPG cylinder will give it 500 rupees. Nothing happened. They said for each farmer, for 1 acre of land, under the Raitu Bharosa scheme, we will give 15,000 rupees. Nothing happened. They also said for each farm laborer in Telangana, every year we will give 12,000 rupees. Nothing happened. They said pension scheme for old age people, our grandfathers and grandmothers, we will give 4,000. Nothing happened. They said for each youth, for their higher education, we will give 5 lakh rupees. Nothing happened. They also said people who fought for the agitation in Telangana, we will give 250 yards of land. And people who don't have a house, we will give 5 lakh rupees. Nothing happened. The reason I am repeating the guarantee of Congress that they gave during the assembly election, because we all know that can never be guaranteed. Congress came to power only on lies. You see the Congress government after they have come to power. The same Chief Minister Revanth Reddy Garu, couple of months back, he said, Modi ji bada bhai, Telangana may I want to bring Gujarat model of development. He said Musi river we will develop like Sabarmati river. He said all those things. Now in Tamil Nadu we say somebody is telling lies, we make them to sit on a donkey. That is a punishment in Tamil Nadu. Especially in rural area, when somebody is telling lies, we make them to sit on a donkey. We allow them to walk with donkey. Here the Chief Minister Revanth Reddy Garu, since he is speaking lies, he is roaming with a donkey egg. Since he is speaking lies, instead of sitting on a donkey, the Chief Minister is roaming around everywhere with a donkey egg in hand, apologizing to the Telangana people that they have come to power by telling lies to you. Across India, including our state Tamil Nadu, we have Fasal Bima Yojana. When there is more rain, the crops got affected, we will get insurance. When there is less rain, there is drought, we will get insurance. But in Telangana state, Fasal Bima Yojana, the insurance scheme of Narendra Modi ji, was not implemented by BRS. Chandrasekhar Rao ji, he said, this is a useless scheme. Now after Congress have come to power, including Revanth Reddy Garu doesn't want to implement. What is happening? In Telangana, we are seeing a sad story. The farmers of Telangana, the farmers of Karim Nagar, the farmers of all parts of Telangana, they are on the verge of committing suicide. The same Congress party, when they came to power, they said, the moment we will come to power, we will waive off all farmer loan up to 2 lakh rupee. And then he said, on Sonia Gandhiji's birthday, we will waive off 2 lakh rupee for each of the farmer. Ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters here, not only have they waived off the farmer loan, not only are they giving 15,000 rupees per acre, not only the laborers are getting 12,000 rupees per acre, this Congress government is a bundle of lies. We all know, other hand, 10 years of Modi ji ka sarkar, we are seeing the performance of Modi ji government. If some developmental work has happened in Telangana, it is only because of our 4 BJP MP under the leadership of Bandi Sanjay Anna. Some developmental work has happened in Telangana. They were able to bring money from the central government to all parts of Telangana. So this election is a message we are going to give to the Congress by winning all Lok Sabha seats, including Karim Nagar, that we don't want Congress party in Telangana. We don't want a party that tells lies in Telangana. We don't want a party that is anti-poor. We don't want a party that is anti-farmer. We don't want a party that is anti-woman. We don't want a party that is anti-youth. My request to all of you in Karim Nagar, it is important that Bandi Anna should win with a big margin. Now all the youth we have assembled here, it is not important we go and vote. On May 13th morning 7 o'clock, Karim Nagar yesterday is 47 degree. Very hot weather. Karim Nagar is already hot. Now Bandi Anna is there, it is double hot now. So political heat is so much in Karim Nagar. Now I am sure everybody in this hall, you will go and vote. But my request to all the youth, Bandi Anna is fighting for your future. Bandi Anna wants you to live in a developed India. Bandi Anna is serving our Honorable PM Narendra Modi Garu to make sure Telangana will reclaim its past glory. Such a state, a resource-rich state, even during the British time, Mughal time, everybody wanted to corner Telangana Hyderabad resource because it is such a fertile area. After independent times to Congress rule and BRS rule, now each child in Telangana, including a child that is not born in Telangana, there is a debt of 1,25,000 rupee in each person's head. Such a great state, both the parties have made into a poor state. Now Bandi Anna, Narendra Modi Garu, all of them are very clear that youth of the state should live in a developed Telangana, where job opportunities are there, where farmers live happily, where all people live happily. For that to happen, the youth have to take up the challenge. We have 5 days. May 13 is the election. Till May 11th, the Pracharam will happen. I request all the youth here to take care of 100 voters starting from today. 100 voters, you know, they are not BJP voters. If really we have to thank Bandi Anna for all the struggle he has gone through, I can tell you, we covered a Padayatra in 230 for Assembly constituency. For 8 months our Yatra happened. It is not easy, sir. It is not easy. One of the toughest things a politician can do is walk for the people. In Telangana hot sun, I came twice for Anna's Praja Sankarama Yatra. 2 times I came. I saw the struggle, the sweat. Every time is walking in that crowd, in that public, everybody wants a photo. Everybody wants to walk with them. I could see the sweat. Very, very tough. He has put his body there. He has sacrificed so much only because he wanted Telangana to prosper.